जय जगन्नाथ। वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक ऑफ यूनिट 1 ऑफ सेक्शन ए बॉटनी एंड द चैप्टर 1 नोन एज रिप्रोडक्शन। सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी द यूनिट 1 एंड चैप्टर 1 ऑफ सेक्शन ए बॉटनी रिप्रोडक्शन। सो व्हाट इज रिप्रोडक्शन? रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए इंपॉर्टेंट फेनोमेना एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म बाय व्हिच ए लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म डिफरेंशिएटेड फ्रॉम ए नॉन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। सो एक्चुअली द रिप्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस, बाय रिप्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस ए ऑर्गेनिज्म क्रिएट ए ऑर्गेनिज्म और ऑफस्प्रिंग लाइक इटसेल्फ। सो इट इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोसेस। रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोसेस फॉर ए ऑर्गेनिज्म बिकॉज बाय दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन ए ऑर्गेनिज्म मेंटेन द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ हिज स्पीसीज। ए ऑर्गेनिज्म फर्स्ट बाथ, टेक बाथ, देन द लाइफ साइकिल अकर्स, फाइनली इट डाई। बट रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फेनोमेनन ऑफ ए ऑर्गेनिज्म। व्हाई? बिकॉज बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन द ऑर्गेनिज्म नॉट ओनली मेंटेन द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ हिज स्पीसीज बट ऑल्सो इट रिसीव्स द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स फ्रॉम द पेरेंट टू द ऑफस्प्रिंग। फ्रॉम द पेरेंट इट रिसीव्स द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। सो रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए इंपॉर्टेंट फेनोमेन। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन? रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस बाय व्हिच ए ऑर्गेनिज्म क्रिएट ए ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक इटसेल्फ टू मेंटेन द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ इट्स स्पीसीज। लेट मी राइट डाउन व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन। व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन? इट इज ए बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस। रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस बाय व्हिच ए ऑर्गेनिज्म क्रिएट ए ऑफस्प्रिंग लाइक इटसेल्फ। सो दिस इज द बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन। ओके, एंड द ऑर्गेनिज्म हुज टेक पार्ट इन हुज द रिप्रोडक्शन अकर्स नोन एज पेरेंट और पेरेंट्स एंड बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन। बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन द इंडिविजुअल और द यंगर वन नोन एज ऑफस्प्रिंग्स और डॉटर्स। व्हाट एवर यू से रिमेंबर ऑफस्प्रिंग्स और डॉटर्स। इट इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फिनोमेनन। इट इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। सो व्हाट इज रिप्रोडक्शन? रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस बाय व्हिच ऑर्गेनिज्म क्रिएट ए ऑफस्प्रिंग लाइक इटसेल्फ। फाइनली वी गेट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन। नेक्स्ट, व्हाट आर द मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन? आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, व्हाट आर द मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन? व्हाट आर द मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन? द मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन इज क्लासिफाइड इंटू थ्री टाइप्स। द मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन इज क्लासिफाइड इंटू थ्री टाइप्स। व्हाट आर दीज? नंबर ए, असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। नंबर टू वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन एंड नंबर थ्री सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। देर आर थ्री मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन बट अकॉर्डिंग टू सम द वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। रिमेंबर इट इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग। सम बायोलॉजिस्ट क्लासिफाई द वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन और दे थिंक दैट और दे कंक्लूड दैट वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। सो दीज आर द बेसिक मोड्स, थ्री टाइप मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन एंड सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। सो फर्स्ट कम टू द असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, what is asexual reproduction? So remember, first of all, I already told you that reproduction is a process, biological process by which an organism create a offspring like itself. So in asexual reproduction, an organism create a offspring like itself, but in this process there is no involvement of gametes, no gametogenesis occurs, no meiosis process occurs, and as usual, if there is no gamete produced, then there is no gametic transfer and no fertilization occurs. And important thing about asexual reproduction, what should be the definition of asexual reproduction? It is a type of reproduction in which one parent involved. There is, remember first, what is asexual reproduction? It is a type of reproduction in which there is no gamete formation, no meiotic cell division occurs, no gametic transfer, no fertilization, no formation of zygote. And another important thing about that, asexual reproduction is only occur by the process of mitosis. So asexual reproduction is also known as somatic reproduction because only mitosis occurs. And as I say that there is no formation of gamete, this process is also known as agamogenesis. So let me write down important thing about asexual reproduction. Only one parent involved, these are the important point. Only one parent involved in this type of reproduction. Only one parent involved, number one thing. Number two, no formation of gametes, there is no formation of gametes in the asexual mode of reproduction. So that's why this process is known as, also known as agamogenesis. Important thing. No gametic transfer occurs. And no fertilization. Also, there is no meiosis or meiotic cell division. No meiosis. There is no meiosis cell division occurs in this mode of reproduction, and only mitosis cell division, mitotic cell division occurs. That's why asexual mode of reproduction is also known as somatic reproduction. Asexual reproduction is also known as somatic reproduction. Here, all the offsprings which are formed from the parent are equally, we can call the offsprings as clone because they are same as the parent. So, asexual reproduction, remember what are the important points? Asexual reproduction, there is only involve of one parent. There is no gamete formation, male or female gamete. So that's why this is also known as agamogenesis. And here, important thing, as usual, there is no gametes are formed. That's why no gametic transfer occurs, no fertilization occurs. And this meiosis process is only occurs due to the formation of gametes. So there is no meiotic cell division. Only mitosis occurs. And from the parent, the individual which are formed or the offspring which are formed in process of asexual reproduction, they are equally same. So that's why the offsprings are otherwise known as clone. Okay. So next, what are the types of asexual reproduction? Our next topic, types of asexual reproduction. There are different types of asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is of different type. How many types? Number one, the important, fission. Number two, budding. Number three, fragmentation. Number four, sporulation. Number five, gemmule formation. These are the types. And there is an important thing about asexual reproduction, the occurrence of asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction occurs in protists, monera, as usual in plants just like algae, fungi, bryophytes and pteridophytes. Okay, so these are the types of asexual reproduction. Number one, fission, budding, fragmentation, sporulation and gemmule formation. First, fission. We will discuss the all types of fission, the characteristics of fission process. So fission is important type of reproduction, asexual reproduction, in which the organism breaks down into two in the process of mitosis or many. Fission. If the organism breaks down into two, then we can call it, as the offsprings are two, so we can call it binary fission. If the parent cell divided into many cells or many offsprings or many clones or many daughter cells, we can call it multiple fission. So fission may be of two types. Number one, binary fission. What is binary fission? The parent cell form two daughter cell. Form two daughter cell. Here the word bi means two. Bi means two. That means from the parent cell, two daughter cell or offsprings are formed. Binary fission. In multiple fission, the parent cell divided into many, more than two or multiples. So that's why this is known as multiple fission. Binary fission and multiple fission. So come to the point, binary fission. Binary fission is basically occur when the organism is in favorable condition. What is favorable condition? That means sufficient food storage, environment condition is properly suitable for the organism. the completely after the complete growth of the organism. Okay, so the important example of, remember what is binary fissure? If the parent is divided into two daughter offspring, binary two, this is binary fissure. If the parent divided into many or multiple offspring, then it is known as multiple fissure. Okay, so binary fission. Take some example of binary fission, then you will understood this very well. So, examples of binary fission. The best example of binary fission occurs in bacteria, also in amoeba, also in urina and paramecium. Okay, let the example of bacteria. Step by step I will say, this is, suppose this is a bacterial cell. Here this is a bacterial cell, this is the cell wall of bacteria, these are the flagella of the bacteria. Important thing, this is mesosome. The cytoplasm of bacteria is modified, is known as mesosome, and the genetic material of bacteria is known as nucleoid or xenophore. So in first step, after the complete growth of bacteria, it maintains the process of fission. All the cellular, here the cell organelles, other types of cell organelles are also present in the bacterial cell. First of all, the nucleoid or the xenophore divided into two parts. In the second step, the nucleoid or xenophore divided into two parts. Here, the division of nucleus or nucleoid. As usual, the division of nucleus, the cytoplasm, all the cell organelles are divided equally. And here a septum is formed. In the third process, here a septum is formed on the bacterial cell. And the nuclei completely divided into two and move to the each pole of bacterial cell, equally distributed by cytoplasm and cell organelles. And this process is occurs in centripetal. Finally, the septum is joined and we get here two bacterial offspring. These are the new bacterial cell or offspring. Completely growth or completely offspring. They now live independently and maintain the life cycle. This is the important process of bacteria, binary fission. Another important example occurs in amoeba. Amoeba is a freshwater living organism. In amoeba or in amoeba, suppose this is the cell of amoeba, these are the pseudopodia. Okay. This is cytoplasm and this is nucleus. In step 1, after the complete growth, during favorable condition, the amoeba first divides its nucleus. The nucleus is divided into two, same equally man, divided into two, division of nucleus occurs, followed by division of cytoplasm and other cell organelles. In the third stage, the amoeba also squeezes at its midpoint. And finally, it detaches and two amoeba or offsprings are produced. Okay, so here from this is the parent cell. Remember, this is the parent cell in which reproduction occurs, and we got two offspring here. So this is known as binary fission. Okay, this is known as binary fission. These are the most important example: bacteria, amoeba, Euglena, paramecium. Now come to the second, known as multiple fission. Multiple fission. As I say, in multiple fission, from one parent, many offsprings are produced. Okay, many offspring are produced from the parents. And if we took some example, you will clearly example of multiple fission occurs in amoeba. Very interesting and very important thing: multiple fission in amoeba. What is the definition of multiple fission? The parents are divided into many cells. Okay, this is known as multiple fission. And in amoeba, binary fission occurs in amoeba during favorable condition. But when unfavorable condition come, just like if the temperature get low, if there is no food is available, if the water, I have already told that amoeba is a what kind of animal? It is a fresh water living animal. So during unfavorable condition, amoeba attend the process of multiple fission. This important process, interesting process known as encystment process. Encystment. Clearly, I will describe it clearly step by step. In the first step, the amoeba, after the complete unfavorable condition, the amoeba first detaches the pseudopodia. It removes all the pseudopodia. And suppose this is the cell membrane, this is the nucleus. In unfavorable condition, in amoeba there is a wall is formed, thick wall known as cyst. A thick wall is formed in the outside of amoeba, and here the nucleus and all the cell organelles, cytoplasm, etc. cell. This is known as this cell wall or this thick wall known as cyst. That's why this process is known as encystment process. This is the step 2. In step 3, when favorable condition occur inside the cytoplasm, the amoeba divides its nucleus into many. The nucleus of amoeba divide into many and form small amoeba. Then known as pseudopodiospore or small amoeba. During favorable condition, the nucleus divide mitotically in mitosis division from 2 cells, 4 cells. Later on, the division continues, and here many small amoeba are formed by the multiple fission mitosis process known as amoebula, or you can call it pseudopodiospore. Okay, and the final step, in final step, the cell wall is detached and the small amoebula or pseudospores are get released into water. Now they live freely and maintain their life cycle. Okay, so this is the complete completely step up and instrument process. It is occurring in unfavorable condition. A thick wall is formed known as cyst. Inside this, the nucleus is divided into many nucleus. And finally, during favorable condition, the thick wall rupture and the small amoeba or pseudospores. Amoeba are released into water. Multiple pigeon also occur inside our body. Remember this. During the parasite is known as Plasmodium vivax, malaria parasite. Multiple pigeon occurs in malaria parasite. Inside our body, the Plasmodium cell in adult cells known as zygote. Multiple pigeon in our body in parasite malaria. Malaria parasite also attend multiple pigeon. The adult parasites known as schizon. And here, by this multiple pigeon process, more number of cells are produced. This process is known as cytokine. Remember, the adult stage, the adult parasite is known as cytokin, and cytokine occurs to form many cells. This is known as multiple fission. Not only in the adult stage, but also the multiple fission also occur in the zygote stage. Okay, so we have completely discussed about the fission. Now our next topic is budding. Okay, let me write down what is budding. Budding. Okay. So budding is also a process of asexual reproduction in which a protuberance or a bud is formed in the parent cell. And the best example of budding, what is budding? A protuberance or bud is formed in the parent cell. Okay, and from the particular site in which or at which the bud is occur, the bud is known as budding zone. The best example of budding occur in yeast. Yeast is a fungi. So example, let take the example of budding in yeast, very important. So yeast is a fungi. This is the structure of yeast. Here this is the nucleus, the cell wall. After the complete, it is occurs in favorable condition. After the complete growth of the yeast, the cytoplasm pushes upwardly, and here a protuberance is formed in the cell wall. This is known as bud, and this area is known as budding area or budding zone. As I say, the nucleus divide into two. In the next step, the nucleus divide into two. As usual, the cytoplasm and cell organelles also divided equally and enter into the bud. After complete the bud is formed, it detaches by a septum. This is the mother or parent, and the bud. Now it is detached. Here a septa is formed after the complete growth of the bud, and the yeast is detached from the parent cell and live freely. here the cell wall pushes, correct? The cell wall form a protuberance like structure or pod in the budding zone, a outgrowth, small outgrowth, and all the cell constituents, cell organelles, the cytoplasm get divided, the cytoplasm and the nucleus are equally distributed, or the flow occur into the bud, and finally when the bud is completely growth, here the bud, a septa is formed, a septum is formed, and the bud is detached from the parent cell. Now it is free, the offspring is free, the offspring now is free. An important question about this process: sometime when sufficient food material is stored in the yeast, then a chain of bud occur in the yeast, and this chain, remember, this chain is known as pseudomycelium. Pseudomycelium. This is very important. Okay. So this is the process of budding occurring in yeast. An important process, important type of asexual reproduction. Our next topic is fragmentation. It is also a type of asexual reproduction in which the parent cell divided into small fragments, and each fragments give rise into a new offspring. And here the most example of fragmentation occurs in Spirogyra. It is an algae, Spirogyra. Let me draw a simple body structure of Spirogyra. These are the cells present in the Spirogyra in favorable condition. The Spirogyra parent cell divided into small fragments. And each fragment give rise to a new Spirogyra or offspring. Here, this is the parent, this is the offspring. So, as the fragments are produced, the name is known as fragmentation, cutting. The body is cut up into different parts. Okay. So, in this video lecture, we discuss the budding, the fission and fragmentation. In our next video lecture, we will discuss the sporulation and other vegetative types of reproduction. Thank you.